heard of a condition where a person can get drunk without drinking alcohol? Believe it or not, this rare phenomena called auto-brewery syndrome actually exists. It gives a whole new meaning to being drunk on light. Auto-brewery syndrome, also known as gut fermentation syndrome, is a condition in which intoxicating quantities of ethanol are produced through endogenous fermentation of carbohydrates, that is, our own fermentation in our body of carbohydrates by particular fungi or bacteria in the gastrointestinal tract. In other words, our gut can brew its own alcohol by fermenting sugary and starchy foods, leading to intoxication and even a measurable blood alcohol level. Now think of how alcohol is usually made. It's the fermentation of yeast or bacteria to a carbohydrate like grapes or grain or potatoes, but it's happening in our gut instead of at the local brewery. One man with the condition was pulled over for erratic driving and blew a 0.2 on the breathalyzer. Now remember, 0.08 is considered hazardous driving. 0.2 on the breathalyzer, insisting that he hadn't touched a drop of alcohol that day. Now you might be wondering, okay, how common is this syndrome? Why haven't I heard of this before? Auto-brewery syndrome is actually considered quite rare. Maybe a few dozen cases reported in the medical literature. However, many experts, and I'm going to include myself as speculating here, believe that it is likely an underdiagnosed condition, a subclinical condition, because its symptoms can mimic many other diseases. Another example, one woman was repeatedly fired from a job for appearing drunk before she was finally diagnosed with auto-brewery syndrome. Who would have thought to test her? If she is falling over, laughing, throwing up, who would have thought to think that this was alcohol if she is a known non-drinker? They would have thought something else was going on. What's actually happening? Several yeast and bacteria species have been implicated in auto-brewery syndrome. Yeast and bacteria species in our gut. The most common culprits are yeast such as brewer's yeast. Not surprisingly, it's called brewer's yeast, Candida up and Candida glabrata, and also Candida krausei. Certain bacteria like Klebsiella pneumonia can also be responsible. Klebsiella pneumonia is a serious pneumonia to have if it's in the lungs, but here it is in the gut, causing another condition. These microbes fermenting in the gut and getting the host intoxicated in the process. Another example, a man's gut was producing so much alcohol that he actually developed a beer belly despite the fact that he was a teetotaler, a non-drinker. Now, certain factors can predispose an individual to developing auto-brewery syndrome. These include, number one, antibiotic overuse, which disrupts the normal gut flora. One person developed auto-brewery syndrome after a course of antibiotics for a dental procedure, which sent his gut biome into a disarray. Low stomach acid, too many antacids, too many medications that bring down the acid in the stomach because the person has heartburn. And a third big one, certain carbohydrate-rich diets feed fermenting microbes. Diabetes, obesity, and liver problems can increase risk. Basically, anything that causes an imbalance in the delicate gut ecosystems will open the door for these alcohol-producing microbes to set up shop. Let's stop for a minute. How common are these risk factors and conditions? Excessive use of antibiotics. Come on, who hasn't used antibiotics too many times because of a cold, a flu? There they are taking another set of antibiotics that year. Low stomach acid due to antacid use because of indigestion. Eating junk food on a regular basis. Isn't this describing many people in our population? Also, let's not forget artificial sweeteners. They've also been shown to induce glucose intolerance by changing gut bacteria. Maybe the use of them also makes the gut a more hospitable environment for these fermenting microbes. And what is the prevalence of diabetes in the population? At least 10% and more, depending on the age group. Obesity. More than 2/3 of the population are overweight and obese. We're talking about a large percentage of the population that have these risk factors for at least a subclinical, undiagnosed level of auto-brewery syndrome. This might be partially the reason why, indeed, 15% of the population struggle with food addiction. The people who struggle with food addiction are almost always people who are eating ultra-processed foods. We've been talking about ultra-processed foods triggering the neuroanatomy of the brain and the hormonal insulin resistance. There could also be this gut biome allowing particular bacteria that ferment sugars into alcohol or ethanol. People who are food addicts will claim that they get food drunk and that they use food like alcohol. It might actually explain why some people struggle to quit sugar and refined carbohydrates. They feel a withdrawal that is similar to a mild alcohol withdrawal. Anxiety, shakes, diarrhea, insomnia. Could it be that they actually are drunk and are detoxing from an undiagnosed mild ethanol use? Good news is treatment. That full-on auto-brewery syndrome, once it's been properly diagnosed, is treatable. You can give antifungal or antibiotics to eradicate the fermenting yeast and the fermenting bacteria. Equally important, switching to a diet that is low in carbohydrates and especially free of processed foods to deprive those microbes of their fuel source. If it's not in the gut bacteria can't be fermenting it. Prebiotics and probiotics may aid in restoring a healthy gut flora as well, especially for people who have the mild syndrome and who don't require actual medications, which I think is actually most of the people that may have this condition. So while the full-on condition itself is quite serious, there's hope. And also for the people who have the subclinical or subliminal type, the food addict will often say that the obsession to overeat and the withdrawal resolves itself once they've cleaned their diet to eating only whole foods. So by raising awareness of auto-brewery syndrome like this video, we can facilitate proper diagnosis and treatment of this rare condition of full-onset auto-brewery syndrome, but we can promote a gut-healthy lifestyle to prevent its development if you are at any level of that disease, the subclinical undiagnosed stage, to not reach its full capacity. We can begin also to see the complex and crazy impact of ultra-processed food on our gut. Let's raise our glasses of kombucha to our happy and healthy microbiome. Thank you.